Hey hippies, welcome, welcome, welcome back. It's me again, Courtney Chavante, back with another awesome tutorial. This one is going to be for a luxury charcuterie or cheese board, so that way you can make your own. But before we get started, make sure you do hit that subscribe button if you aren't subscribed yet, and also hit that notification bell so that way you don't miss anything that I do put out for you guys moving forward. Alright hippie, so to get started, what we're going to do is we're just going to go ahead and open and prep our board. I got this bamboo board off of amazon.com. I'll make sure I do have it linked below for you as well. I liked this one because it had these little utensils and everything that came with it. This adorable little magnetic case that attaches it to the actual charcuterie board. And it also has like these little open spaces for sauces or crackers or just something you want to section off to the side. So I thought that was really dope and everything. So I decided on this particular model, but of course, you know, there are so many different kinds you can use and everything. Just choose which one speaks to you and surf through a couple and everything. And yeah, so what you're gonna see me do here first is I'm just going to like kind of remove all the plastic and everything and see where everything is. Now I did go around and trace sort of where the where the utensils were going to sit and everything, but what I will say is that this step was unnecessary because I end up going with a completely different design and everything than what I initially started out doing and whatnot. But you know, if you do need to section something off, you can go ahead and put this liquid latex on the bottom of the board, and you can also put it on the sides, which I failed to do. So I do have some spillage over onto the sides that are going to stay onto the cheese board. So if you want to avoid that, I would definitely suggest making sure that, you know, you just kind of look out for that and everything. So yeah, you're just going to see me apply this liquid latex on here, and then I'm going to let it dry until it turns clear, and then we are going to, you know, move on to the next step. Alright hippies, so to start out, what we're going to do is we're just going to be painting a white layer of with acrylic paint on here. So I'm going to be going around where I put that liquid latex, but again, if you are going to be doing the design that I am doing, you do not need that liquid latex portion sectioned off, and you will be actually painting over where those magnets are. And what I'm painting is like sort of like this kind of wavy line and everything. I'm just kind of to section off the corner of my cheese board, and then I'm going to let this dry. Alright, after that white layer has dried, I'm going to go right back over it. I'm going to paint a purple layer right on over on top of that white acrylic paint. Now, what I'm going to be doing off camera is I'm also going to be painting where the little holes are as well. So those little cubby holes at the bottom, those are going to get a layer of paint too. You can do the white. I didn't do the white, so you'll be able to see kind of like what that looks like at the end and everything. But I'm going to still use the same exact purple color that I am using on top of this white within those little holes and everything, so that way I can continue on, you know, with my design. And then once you finish with this purple layer, you're going to let this dry completely. Alright hippies, so once that's dry, what you're going to do is you're just going to go ahead and pop open your polyurethane. I am using this Brightone, and I'm just using a pipette to stir it up right quick, and just put a little bit off into a little medicine cup that I have here on the side. and I also have some iridescent crushed glass that I'll be working with in this step as well, along with this little tiny spoon that I will be using to scoop up with the crushed glass, so that way I can avoid like cutting my fingers or anything like that. Now to start, what you're going to do is you're just going to brush on that bright tone right along the edge where that purple is, and then you're going to spoon that crushed glass right on top so it can cover the polyurethane. So that polyurethane is essentially going to act as a glue for your crushed glass, and you're just going to continue doing this all along on where this meets and everything, and just making sure that you have it at a thickness that you want. If you want more glass, add a little bit more polyurethane, make that line a little bit thicker. If you want a little less, then, you know, make it thinner, of course. This is completely up to you and to your judgment and what you find attractive and pretty. So have fun with this part, hippies. And I'm going to, like, kind of just continue on with this portion of it and everything. After I finish laying all this, you're going to see me come through with a pipette. I'm just going to add a few drops of the polyurethane on top just to kind of further seal everything in and keep any pieces of crushed glass from, you know, floating or falling away or anything like that. But yes, go ahead and enjoy the little time lapse until we are ready to move on to our next step. Alright, so now it's time for our next step, hippies. So we're going to be doing the same exact thing, except for this time we're going to be placing our amethyst chips. Now these are just some pieces, some tiny little pieces of amethyst that are tumbled and everything. So they are, they're smoothed out so that way they don't have any sharp edges like the raw stones would. And what I'm doing is I'm putting a little line, I'm brushing that polyurethane, that bright tone, right next to where that iridescent crushed glass is, and I'm just going to line these amethyst chips up right along there just to add, you know, just a little bit more stuff on here to make it look interesting. I think the amethyst chips are so pretty, and it's going to also help act as a little barrier as well, so that way when we come in and pour our resin, it will help keep it from overflowing onto the board. So yeah, just a little heads up, that's going to help with that too. Just go ahead and continue placing these chips, hippies. I'm going to catch you after the rest of this portion. Excuse me. I'm going to catch you after the rest of this portion of this particular part of the time lapse, and then we'll move on to our next step. All right, hippies, so now that that has had a chance to completely dry, what you're going to do is you're just going to mix up some white and some purple pigment powder. I am using some mica powders with this, and I don't think, actually, did I? No, I don't think I came in with any alcohol ink, but if you do want to, you know, kind of brighten up the color or anything like that, you can always add in a couple drops of alcohol ink just to make sure that you get the hue that you want. And then feel free to add in more powders and everything too, just to make sure that, you know, it's at the consistency and everything that you need. Oh, I actually did come in through with the alcohol ink, so you guys can see how I actually made those colors deeper and everything. You guys know I love mixing my pigments so I can really, really get the colors that I want. And as you can see, I went ahead and painted those little cubbies and everything too with the same color purple. They look a little bit different because I didn't do the primer white onto the cubby part. So yeah, it's still going to look really, really nice with the resin though. So what you're going to do is you're going to start pouring your resin. You want to be very careful. You don't want to be too heavy handed with this portion. And you're just going to kind of pour the resin over the painted areas and be mindful of where the resin is going. Go ahead and pour it into the little cubby holes too, since those areas are painted. Come in with that white color just so we can make sure that, you know, this stays interesting, and we just add a little bit of dimension in here. Come in into those empty spaces. You want to completely cover all those painted areas with resin. So just really get in there and everything and make sure that, you know, you got it exactly how you want it. Spread it around. Do not be shy. It's completely fine to get in there with a popsicle stick, because you don't want to make these layers too thick, because you still want things to be able to sit on top, and you still want the magnets to be able to work to a certain degree as well when it comes to putting on those utensils that were in the little utensil holder. So just keep all that in mind and everything as you're moving along. Now, if you hippies are really enjoying like a lot of the color mixes I am using here and just a lot of the supplies that I am using on this board, feel free to check out my Etsy store, where I do have so many different products available on there for you guys to help with your, you know, your resin needs and just so many different craft things. I have mystery boxes, I have glitters, I have foils, I have molds, I have so much more, and I have even more to come. So make sure you do check that out for me. It is linked below, and you can also get a discount by using the code YouTube at checkout. So I got you covered. Check me out, hippies. Alright, so what we're going to do is, after we finish, you know, pouring that resin in, you're just going to kind of go through with the popsicle stick, and you can also get in here with a toothpick as well, because you want to blend these colors into each other a bit as well, so that way you can just kind of make it more interesting a bit. I'm also going to come in with whatever white is remaining and pour into the portion that doesn't have any white in there, just because I want it all to match and I want it all to kind of follow the same theme. So I just want to make sure that I'm paying attention to the different colors and everything that I'm adding, how I'm adding it, and just making sure that it all blends. So, you know, follow your heart on here. You know, with art, there's no right or wrong way to really do it. You're just really doing what you feel and what comes to you naturally, and that's why the things changed up so much on here. But yeah, so just go ahead and continue going on with that toothpick and everything. Spray some alcohol if you need to. You know, just do whatever you need to achieve the look that you need to and everything. Don't spend too much time on this step, because it is not going to stop here. We have so much more to add on. I'm going to let you guys go ahead and watch what I continue to do and everything. And I will catch you on to the next step after we let this cure. All right, hippies, so that resin has completely cured for us. So what we're going to do is we're going to be adding in just some more interesting factors here. I'm using some mica powder and also a really fine gold holographic glitter, and I'm going to mix these together. Mica powder is in a copper color, which is really, really pretty. It's in the gold family, so I'm using like a lot of metallics here. I'm just going to use my pipette to put the polyurethane in there and just kind of mush this together and mix it until I have a nice pasty color that looks like a nice thing, a paint, and it's not all chunky. I'm able to, you know, get all the chunks of that mica powder out of there along with that glitter and make sure it's mixed thoroughly. Take your paintbrush and you're just going to dab this into the center where that white is. You want to be careful without completely covering that white area. You want it to kind of poke through around the surrounding edges. So you want to kind of focus this copper color in the middle center part of where all this white is and everything. It just kind of go through all across the board. Feel free to switch up brushes as well. You're going to see me actually switch to a smaller brush so that way I can get into those little nooks and crannies. And I really just want to follow the pattern of what this white is doing. So whatever the white is doing, I'm going to make this copper do just kind of smaller and concentrate it towards the middle. So I hope that makes sense. I'm going to zoom in for you a bit as well so that way you can see a little bit closer in and everything. But I'm not going to continue talking through this step and everything because I pretty much said all I had to say regarding how to do this. So I'm just going to let you hippies enjoy this time lapse and everything and enjoy the painting and whatnot so that way you can see how I make this piece even more interesting. All right, hippies, once that layer is dry to touch, what you can do is you can go ahead and pop out with this Pabeo acrylic outliner paint. This is a silver color, which I will have linked below for you in the description as well. I got this from Amazon, and what I'm doing is I'm going inside the middle of that copper layer that is in the middle of that white layer, and I am going to just kind of do this nice little outline, kind of mimicking the outline of that copper part and everything. And this is just going to be where I'm going to hold the glitter and everything so I can make sure it doesn't spill over, and we're going to get in there and make it even more interesting. So basically what we're doing is we're just going to be layering and layering and layering so that way we can make sure that we achieve a look that we are happy with. So continue on with this Pabeo outliner, outline those copper areas and everything, and then we're going to let this dry. All right, hippies, so you know the drill. We're gonna go ahead and pop open our trusty dusty brightener, and we're going to just add a few drops into a very fine silver glitter that I have here. And I'm just going to make sure that I have this into a nice paste consistency, but to where it's not too pasty, to where it's not, so it can still be like a tad bit runny and blend into the other colors, because we want to make sure we're able to blend this with another glitter that we are going to be using in a later step, in the very, very next step before this even gets a chance to dry. So what you're going to do is just kind of go along the inside of that silver outliner that we did on the last step, and you're just going to add in a nice thick layer of this fine silver glitter that we are going to be using here. And you know, just continue going in with your small brush and just dropping this in here, and you're going to do this into the little cubby areas. Anywhere that you put this silver outliner paint, this is where you're going to be adding some silver glitter. I'm going to allow you hippies to enjoy the time lapse and just kind of see what I do here, since I have done this so many steps before. I don't want to talk your head off and everything, so I really don't have much to say about this step. But yeah, just go ahead and continue on, and I'll catch you when we move on to a different glitter color. Alright hippies, so now it's time to pop in with another color. This is going to be just a chunky purple color that I have here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix that with the polyurethane as well, get that pasty color going. And then I'm also adding in some fine purple glitters just to make sure that, you know, I cover all my bases and I can help make sure that it blends into that silver glitter better when there's a lot of fine glitters mixed in too. So right in the middle of the silver glitter is where I'm going to be concentrating this purple glitter mix, and this is just going to help blend into that kind of geode looking thing in the middle and everything. And then it's going to blend into the silver color and it's going to look so pretty and just add a little bit more dimension and everything and kind of help on with what we're got going on here. We just want to give this like a lot to look at and everything. Like I said, Boujie Hippie is a femme apothecary for, you know, sultry stoners and everything. We're a luxury femme apothecary for sultry stoners. So I like creating pieces that's so easy and really mesmerizing for you to get lost in. And I just want you to be able to stare at a piece for like 30 minutes, like just zoned out and not even notice that you did it. So that is always my goal here. And that's always what I'm going for. And that's why I am always doing so much. You are not really going to catch too much minimalism over here. Like, this is Boujie Hippie, not minimalist hippie. So this is what we got going on here. But yeah, just go ahead and continue adding in that purple and everything. And then I'm going to catch you guys once we come in with our last color. Alright hippies, so this is our last color right here. Yay! So what you're going to do is you're going to take this really fine gold glitter, mix that with the bright tone or polyurethane or your varnish, whatever it is that you are using for this particular step. And then you can just go ahead and use that brush, and this time you're going to outline that copper space. So where you painted that copper on way earlier, a couple steps back, you're just going to go ahead and outline those little pieces and everything with this fine gold glitter. So that way it just creates a nice little pop in everything, and it helps break up where that copper and that white meets even more. And it just helps make this look even more intentional and everything, and even more natural. Or if this can look natural, I'm not even sure if natural is the right word, but it goes, sis. It goes. So you're gonna continue on with this fine gold glitter and that polyurethane mix, and just continue going around the copper area and making it look really pretty. You know, use that brush to break it up. Don't let it get too thick. You just want it to be a nice little outline because you want the copper to still shine through and be really, really bright. So you don't want this part to be as thick as you did the silver or that purple area. Go ahead and enjoy the time lapse, hippies, and I will catch you on the other side once we get ready to go ahead and seal all this in.
Thank you.
Alright hippies, so for this step, what I did was I went ahead and moved over to my leveling board. I have a leveling board linked below for you as well that I found on Amazon. The leveling boards are super dope because if you are in an area where it's not completely level, you can make sure that your pieces still are and it's completely adjustable and everything, so you're able to turn the little knobs and everything to make sure that it's level in your particular unlevel area. But what I did was I went ahead and mixed up some clear resin and everything, and I'm just using my mixing stick to add on this resin in a nice thick top coat layer, so that way this can go ahead and seal in everything that we have here. I want to go ahead and seal in this glitter. I want to seal in those tumbled amethyst chips. I want to seal in that crushed glass and everything, and I just want to make sure that this layer is nice and smooth. I am taking my time and I am spooning it on here. This is going to help make sure that it prevents any dips or anything. I don't know if you've noticed that sometimes that if you just, you know, pour the flood coat on and just like pour it on there, sometimes it creates these little indentions and dimples and everything. And when you spoon it on like this, I noticed that that occurs way less. So, you know, just a heads up with that. I am making sure that I am covering each and every inch of where these like surfaces are, but I am trying my best not to let it leak onto where the actual bamboo and the empty spaces are. So I do not want any clear resin where the bamboo or the faux wood, whatever your cutting board happens to be made out of, I don't want the resin on there because I want to make sure that where the food is sitting is 100% food safe. I will not be placing any food items onto where this resin portion is, and I wouldn't suggest that you do so either unless you are using a resin that is food safe and FDA, you know, regulated and everything. But even still, I probably still would not sit my open food like directly on top of any resin. But you know, that's just me. Do as you wish. We're all grown here. Don't say Courtney Shavonte came telling you to do anything. Hit me with no lawsuits, because I did not and I will deny it. So just make sure that this layer is completely even. Go around all those edges, make sure you touch every edge just to ensure that there is some resin touching there. If you have any spillage, no worries hippies, it's completely easy to, you know, cover that up and everything and make sure you're able to clean that up. What you're going to do is you're just going to take a rag is like old or anything to clean up with, spray some alcohol, and then you're gonna spray some alcohol on the rag and just wipe it clean. It will come right on up, and then you're just going to let this completely cure. All right, hippies, here is our baby. She is absolutely stunning. This is definitely an original Courtney Shavonte Boujie Hippie work of art here. You are going to be seeing the charcuterie board come up in so many videos that I have coming up for you guys. Hint, hint on you if you can do anything with that information that I just blessed you guys with and everything. But here's some close-ups and everything on how it turned out. I am really loving like how this little utensil piece just sits on here. It's magnetic. Although it doesn't completely secure it, you can't just shake it or anything, but it does add another layer of protection so that way it doesn't just fall off, and it pulls off easily without any scratches or anything like that. I'm just gonna lay it here so that way you guys can see how this portion of it turned out. I am so in love with this piece, hippies. Like, look at this crushed glass and this amethyst, like, just kind of surrounding, like, this little abstract, like, little design that I have going on here. If you are loving this tutorial as much as I am, make sure you leave me a like and a comment. I love hearing from you, hippies. Feedback is a gift, and you guys be making me laugh. Like, I really love it. Until next time, I really hope you, like, really enjoyed this. XO, hippies. Mwah. Catch you later.